Okay, so we are recording our first video.
This is being back.
No, we recorded one in a brie.
No, I meant in the house.
Oh, yeah.
Like this place that they remember us.
As you can see, we got some new wallpaper!
Yep. And speaking of new things, I
If
don't
you
know what
think
you
it's
guys
cute,
think.
drop in the comments!
Okay, I was talking about my hair now. I don't know what you guys think about my new hairstyle.
I don't know what you guys think of my new hairstyle. It's called curtain bangs, and my sister recommended for me to get it.
I don't know what mine is called.
Yours are called very cool.
Anyway, guys, it's good to be here. It's good to be back on this couch recording a video. We hope you guys are doing good. My name is Kwame, and this is.
My name is Elaine.
And this is our channel.
This is Kwame's channel.
So I don't know. So this is interesting because before this was possible, Elaine wouldn't sit here with me. And the particular story we're gonna tell you about, I mean, when I started this channel, she was the one person who was supporting me a lot to be able to even start the channel. And she didn't appear on the channel until late 2020. And I mean, before that, we had been going to places, I
Yes,
think.
we would do the travel vlogs together,
Yeah, but she
but
never spoke.
yes.
And then we did one, two, three, and now everybody's talking about Elaine, 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 Elaine. Every video we put out there, yeah, your wife is so cool, your wife is that, your wife is this. And
I'm not school people, I'm not.
I'm just thinking that maybe, okay, I've also shifted most of my work documentaries to another channel called Asitna. And so I'm thinking maybe in 2022 we make this Kwame and Elaine channel.
I don't know why you're.
I don't know, because people seem to like it. And you know, I kind of like it too. So
Okay, well.
it's something to think about. If you guys think
Our channel is a democracy, so.
That it should be a Kwame and Elaine channel, like the pinned comment. I'm pinning a comment, yeah. Like it. If you think it shouldn't be, comment why not on the pinned, as in reply the pinned comment. Yeah. So today we're talking about how we ended up.
In the German Cosmopolitan.
Yeah. So it's an interesting story. I think it's a full circle kind of story. From like when I started this conversation right now, from starting this channel to her not appearing, to her not wanting to record videos usually, to coming on to the German.
December edition of Cosmopolitan. So maybe you've seen it, but Kwame and I have shared an excerpt of picture
Yeah.
of a page of the German Cosmopolitan. I don't know how are you on your
I'm not on
phone?
my phone. I was looking for the email so
Oh,
you could read the interpretation
okay.
for them.
Oh, okay. Sorry, I thought
Wow.
it was. This should go into our pet peeves video coming up. So as you probably seen or not, and then you're seeing it now because Kwame is going to edit it woof, into this video, the excerpt of the German Cosmopolitan.
Cosmopolitan, yeah.
I wanted to share the story because everybody's asking how, why, and all these things of how you got into a printed Cosmopolitan. For me, it is a big thing because when I was in high school, I used to love magazines. Like,
You still do,
I
actually.
still do. Like,
Yeah,
I
she
mean,
reads
there's not.
magazines religiously.
No, not religiously, but I like to buy them for one. I mean, it's something so luxurious, right? Who really needs a
Yeah, for you to
magazine?
actually buy an actual copy magazine in a world where digital magazines and everything, people just scroll,
Yes.
it's a love. It's a love
Yeah, it's
thing.
nice. I like it. And it comes from high school. Me and my friends would buy magazines, then we exchange them, all these things. And I would used to read Cosmopolitan and Celebrity and Tina for all the Dutch watchers. So it's a big thing. And we wanted to share this story because everyone was asking, why, why? But I think for us, for me, it's a very humbling experience as it's a story of like small beginnings and you never know who is watching. So how we ended up in Cosmopolitan was, I've been stepping into the YouTube channel or on the YouTube train, as I always call it. Because I think it's important that we share our story, that we share our experience.
Exactly why should become a Kwame and Elaine. Go on. Okay.
You're interrupting my story.
Okay, sorry.
I think it's important to show our authentic selves and show that intercultural and interracial relationships can work. It's a lot of work, but it's working and we are thriving, we are learning, we are growing every day. And that's what we like to share here. And I think the love languages concept came in because we thought it's something that everybody can relate to. So we thought, let's make an episode on it.
Yeah.
Also, we like the concept because there's no right or wrong. It's just a tool to develop yourself in your relationship. So that's how we came to that episode. But the funny thing is that how we ended up in Cosmopolitan actually started in 2013. Because
that's the long story.
2013.
Yeah.
That's how long this goes back. So before I even knew Kwame existed, I went on an exchange semester. So I was studying in Netherlands at Wageningen University.
Yeah.
And if you know, you know. And
what the hell is that?
Not everybody knows Wageningen, but if you know, you know.
Okay.
And I would go on an exchange semester in Budapest, so in Hungary. And this was before Budapest was something cool. So it was before all the tourists came. So it was still quite Eastern European.
You mean Budapest is now cool?
Very booming.
Oh.
And okay. It's great, like, but we came just before everybody else kind of explored it, and it was still very Eastern European, a lot of communists, like, artifacts still there. People spoke barely English. Luckily, I chose all English courses, and there was a small group of exchange students, so I met people from Ireland, I met people from Germany, I met people from Netherlands, I met people from Spain, Portugal, you name it, USA, everybody was there. We were a big group of international students. Well, not really big, but it was like maybe 30 people.
It's big for foreign students.
Yeah, so like 30 people. And
that's a big
number.
We
would all go out to the same places and drink lots of beers and everything. And one of them became a friend. I don't know if I should mention his name because...
No.
The name is not important, but he knows who he is. One of them, a guy from Germany, became a friend. He was also in my gender studies class, and he was very, I don't know, we got along well. We went on trips together with the whole group, and it was just fun. We would go to house parties, all these things. And I mean, as things go, you follow each other on Facebook, social media, you keep up a little, but in the end, we lost kind of track of like our contact.
Yeah.
And that's now about seven.
Or so you thought. That you've lost track.
Yeah, I mean, you would see each other's social media and then you would
every
reply every now and then, but it's...
That, yeah, it's not such a big deal, I mean...
Yeah, you're not in each other's every day, but you wish each other the best. That's kind of the sentiment I had. And then suddenly one night, or day, I don't even know why I said night, I look at Instagram and... sometimes you get these requests from people who don't follow you. And I'm like, okay. Most of the times it's just spam. So I just think like, I'm sure it's nothing. And then actually the partner of my friend from Budapest reached out to us. So it turned out that she's an independent journalist writing in Germany.
Yeah.
And I think married or they are together now with my friend. She was writing an article on love languages, and
around the time, like that's the beauty of serendipity. Right around the time when we are released the video,
exactly. And funny enough, I didn't even know, but my friend from Germany has been watching our vlogs or keeping up with our vlogs.
Yeah,
and she asked us, "Would you be interested to be interviewed?"
Yeah.
For the love languages thing. And I was like, this is such a long way coming, but
yeah.
it really shows that the internet is such a crazy place, because somebody I met 8 years ago, when I didn't even know you existed, is now connecting us to his partner who's gonna write an interview about us. So
I tried looking for the email, I couldn't find it.
And all of a sudden, now we were enthusiastic. I asked her back, and she said she sent a few questions over email. We sat down, we tried to come up with like the answers and see also how it goes about. And then and we're like, okay, cool, let's see how it goes, if it will be published. She also said, like, when will it be published? We asked, and then she said December. We're like, okay, let's see. So she sent us shared our answers, and she put it together and translated for us in English, as we don't, well, I should be able to at least read German, but...
You want to translate it?
No. I can't do that on the spot.
Yeah, that's what I was looking for, the email.
Okay, we are back. Where's the email? So I will read it out, and maybe Kwame will put it on the screen, but then you can just listen to my voice.
Wait, the article, right? In English?
Yeah.
Yeah, I can't put the whole thing on the screen, come on.
People can just read, you can put it under here.
No, it's too much. Thank
okay,
you.
Elaine Wilke, 29, project manager, and also Kwame Bonsu, 33, filmmaker.
Yes.
Are you looking at the email?
Yes.
On your phone?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So no phone needed during vlogs.
Okay, you read.
The love languages are a good tool to talk about what the other person needs. We understand each other better now. At the beginning of our 6-year relationship, there were frequent misunderstandings. For example, if Grammy wanted to drop me off or pick me up somewhere in Accra, where we live, I wanted to be independent and insisted on going out on my own. Mm-hmm. But Kwame was only interested in doing something for me and showing his love. His love language is acts of service. Mine is quality time. Talking, watching a movie together, cooking, eating together without cell phones. That in turn is not so easy for Kwame. As a freelance filmmaker and voice actor, he must be available for professional reasons.
Yes.
That's what he always says, but anyway.
Yes. He's like, I'm active on social media.
But you don't have to be 24/7 active.
You finish. I'll tell
so
them.
So eating together without cell phones. That, in turn, is not so easy for Kwame as a... Oh, I already read that, but I'll just continue. As a freelance filmmaker and voice actor, he must be available for professional reasons. He's trying to put the phone down for quality time, but honestly, it's still a hot topic between us. Didn't notice?
Oh, okay.
We're not perfect and keep falling into old patterns. But I also do my best to speak Kwame's love language. Sometimes I make him tea, sometimes I prepare dinner, and now I also allow him to take care of me. Sometimes I even ask him if he can pick me up from work. And so if you were curious what was going to be written about us, this is the piece. Maybe they changed this a little bit, but...
Yeah, but that's the general idea of what was written. And yeah, overall, I just think it's just really powerful. I never for one thought that when I was starting this channel 2 years ago, that at any point, first of all, that Elaine would be on the channel, and secondly, that this would lead to something like this. I mean, it's not like an award or achievement or anything, but it's such a power of social media moment for us.
Yeah.
You know, how far you reach without even knowing it, and how, you know, deep these influences are. So if you're doing something on social media and you think nobody's looking, a lot of people are looking. If you're doing something about your work, something that you love, I think that you should just keep doing it. Be consistent, be original, be authentic, be happy with what you're putting out there. And somebody will find you.
Yeah, you never know who's watching.
Yeah.
You never know who is in your network, even not your active network, but...
Just will be able to, on the spot, you know...
Connect you.
Yeah,
and I think it's really encouraging. And it also reminds me, like, okay, we are doing something and people appreciate it. Up to the point that they want to write something about us. For me, it's very surreal, because that's not why we started it. we started it because we thought it was important to tell our story, but the fact that somebody's putting that into print, and hopefully we can hold that print at some point.
Yeah.
That's just really cool, and it motivates me at least to, you know, keep on doing this and be aware
that it motivates her to keep on doing it.
And be aware that
2022.
You should honor your small beginnings, even though they're small, they can have an impact. And never did I thought when I was reading Cosmopolitan in high school
that you end up with
in
the magazine.
For what would I end up in the magazine, you know?
And you know, yeah.
I mean, it's not a cover thing or like, but it's a beginning.
It's a beginning.
Yeah.
You want to be excited to get it?
Many more.
Okay.
Whatever is coming, we are ready.
All right. So yeah, that's what we wanted to share with you guys. We'll catch you in hopefully a few more, maybe another video before the year ends. It's December. We hope your year is going well so far. No, your December is going well. Not your year is going well so far.
I hope you had a good year.
Yes. But yeah, hopefully we come your way again with another video before the year ends. So.
A special thanks to my friend in Germany and his partner for reaching out to us and honoring our work like that. Yeah. We're not putting your names out there, but you know who you are. And thanks so much. It really motivates us and we appreciate it so much.
Yes, Kwame and Elaine 2022.
Bye.
Bye.